Hi everyone, this is Lee. Welcome back to the channel. I've been learning game development with Unity in 1 year. I want to take this opportunity to review the progress and share with you guys where the channel is heading. If this is your first time here, you want to see videos about game development and programming, please consider subscribing to the channel and turn on the bell, then you won't miss my next video. Without further ado, let's get started. I started learning Unity and making a game in January 2019. If you follow the channel, you know I've been working as a programmer for years, but I haven't made any games before, even I quite interested in it. Because I was busy with my daily job, running the business and take care of the investment and family. Once the business and the investment on the track, I have some time to do something else. The first thing I would like to do is to make games. I didn't spend a lot of time planning because I know if I didn't do it now, I will regret it in the future. The first thing I need to do is to choose a game engine. If you just start making a game, this is the first thing you have to decide. After reviewing some game engines on the market, I choose Unity. Because I use C# for many years, it would be easier for me to get started quickly. I still remember that it took me some time to get familiar with the Unity environment. I started playing some demos and reviewed the code. Gradually, I start getting a feel about game development. I'm always a big fan of turn-based strategy game because I enjoy the time on planning and solve the challenging situation by using the proper strategies. Sometimes, I took it as a life simulator because if you want to live a better life, we have to plan the moves, try different strategies, and learn things quickly from our failures. I also like to play chess when I was a kid. Because it's my first game, I want to make a small, casual, and fun game. I'm taking it as a project for learning purpose instead of making a commercial game. I don't have any financial pressures, even I work as a solo game developer. But when I decide to do something, I still try my best. I always treat commercial success as a side product when I did a good job. At the same time, I started my YouTube channel, as I have heard that it's necessary to let more people know about your game, especially for solo game developer. Marketing could be a challenger here. I uploaded videos about game development progress every week. Then I started getting feedback and comments about my game. I was really excited. By now, I got over 800 subscribers and over 100 members in the Discord server. Thanks for everyone who subscribed to the channel and joined the Discord server. I appreciate your support. I couldn't improve the game quickly without your help. If you want to set up a YouTube channel for your game development, one suggestion I have is that you should find your own pace. Because making a video is a very time-consuming task, especially if you want to make some valuable and high-quality videos for our audience. Do you want to be a YouTuber or game developer, or both of them? By answering these questions, it will help us to allocate our time and resource properly. One suggestion here is no matter what happens, don't push yourself too much because you may burn out quickly. No matter you treat your game development as a hobby or a business, think about it in the long term. It is your game, it is your channel, it is your life. You have the right to do it in the pace you feel comfortable. At the same time, I also tried to learn more skills in game development by adding more and more game mechanics. One thing I have learned during this process is that we should be confident to share the progress with other people. I like the words shameless show off. No matter how little the progress is, we should have the guts to show it to other people. We can get some more feedback on the game and mechanics. I'm always open to any suggestions. If I think the features and mechanics can fit into the game very well, I will try to implement quickly and share the progress on the Discord server, Facebook, and other social media. One suggestion here is that it is okay to share the progress, but don't annoy other people too much. Otherwise, people may not like to provide any feedback to you anymore. Now, more content is put into the game. I still take a lot of time to think about how to make the game more fun rather than making it more complicated. In my spare time, I would like to join the indie game development community. A lot of game developers publish their progress and updates. It is so exciting to see other people are making some pretty impressive games. It motivates me to keep working on my current project. If you start making a game, I would suggest that you should join the community as early as possible. Because I'm active in social media and game development community, from time to time, I got contacted by different artists, musicians, and translation services. I appreciate your trust and interest in this game. Believe it or not, I even got contacted by some game publishers. I didn't see this coming when I started this project. That's why I decided to put some more time and efforts into this project. The bar for commercial products is higher than the hobby project. Even I have been working on software development for years, I think I got a mindset ready. But I still don't know if it will turn into a good game or not. Anyway, I'm willing to accept this challenge. I plan to release this game as early access next year, so I set up the Steam page in October. Because the trailer is required to set up the page, I took some time to make a gameplay trailer. I don't know what will happen later on, but I'm just so glad I decided to make a game 12 months ago. I enjoy every day of this journey so far. The most important is that I got a chance to know so many talented game developers around the world. I also got a lot of support from the community and my audience. I'm a solo game developer, but I'm not alone because all the supporters, you guys rock. At the end of 2019, I wish all of you a happy new year. I've been working on game development and keep making weekly videos for 1 year. I will keep doing the same thing in the next year. It is not that easy. If you are making games and videos in the same time, you will know what I'm talking about. I couldn't do it without your support. If you want to support me to keep working on the game and videos, please consider subscribing to the channel and turn on the bell. Then you will get notified when I upload new videos. Thanks for watching. This is Lee. I will see you next year.